Good morning, dear students. I am Vishwaradya R. Kardalli, the Department of English. I have been teaching English from last 9 years. I am working as a lecturer in English. So, as we are aware that because of this coronavirus, COVID-19, so we could not attend, we could not conduct offline classes, regular classes, so that the management of Sri Guru Independent PU College has decided to conduct online classes. Today, I will just talk about the language and literature and fourth chapter, Oru Manushan by Vaikam Muhammad Bashir. Dear students, because of this pandemic, the PU board has decided and it has deleted 4 chapters from the syllabus. As you have all got 2 books of English, one is Reflection and another one is Articulation. In the Reflection, we had 13 chapters, and in those 13 chapters, 4 chapters have been deleted, removed from the syllabus. The removed chapters are chapter number 3, Around a Medicinal Creeper, and poem number 5, Money Madness, and chapter number 10, Frederick Douglass, and last one, poem 13, Do Not Ask of Me, My Love. These are the 4 chapters have been deleted from the syllabus, and remaining 9 that already 2 have been discussed by first chapter, The Gentleman of the Jungle and The School Boy. Both the chapters were discussed by my dear colleague Dr. Prabhakar Patil. So today I will narrate you the story Oru Manushan, which is written by Vaikam Muhammad Bashir. As I know that you have come from different schools and different places, and some of you have studied English as a first language, and some of you have studied English as a second language. Keeping in that in my mind, I just define what is language and what is literature, what is grammar. If you see that language, along with, if you had studied 3 languages, along with mathematics, social science and science, as you have chosen here purely physics, chemistry, mathematics and biology, along with that 2 languages, one is English, which is compulsory, and the second one is choice, either you can take Hindi or Kannada. So you are all aware that you studied 3 languages, you may speak 3 languages, you may write 3 languages perfectly, no question. So language, why along with these branches of science we should study languages? What is the importance of language? Dear students, you see, language is basically, it's a medium of communication. It's a tool of communication through which we can express our ideas, our emotions, our knowledge, our feelings. We can share with our fellow friends wherever we live. And language basically means for communication. Human beings are unique because they have their own particular language to speak. So along with language, we have to understand literature also. Language and literature. Bhashe matu sahitya. Literature, language is a means of communication, it's a tool of communication through by which we can understand a person, or we can share our knowledge, information, our feelings, our emotions with the fellow person or the fellow being is language. And literature is what? So literature is such a vast an area or a form, that literature is an expression, overall expression of life through the form of or through the medium of language. Literature is an expression of overall life through the form of writing, or by the medium of writing is called literature. It could be the lifestyle, it could be culture, tradition, manner, behavior, system, everything. So whatever we feel, perceive, understand, experience in life, when we share with someone through the medium of writing is called literature. So language and literature are the part of life. So every student must know, and it is inevitable to know the language as well as literature. Whereas language gives us, it gives us confidence, and it gives, you know, the language, through language we have to learn skills of, skills like how we are going to acquire the language, how we are going to master on particular language. There are very basic skills are 4, LSRW. They are listening, speaking, reading and writing. Dear students, as we know that listening and speaking has been happening here, it's not particularly only students, but every human being on this earth, they listen a language and they speak language. But particularly students, they along with listening, speaking, they even read the language and even write. So these are the very basic skills to acquire or master on a language, that listening, speaking, reading and writing. And next one, as I said, that literature, there are forms of literature. So it could be a story, it could be a novel, a fiction, a poem, a ballad, a drama, cinema. So these are all comes under, you know, literature. These are the forms of literature. So reading literature enhances our way of thinking, perception, understanding life in a better way. That is the reason one has to read literature and understand life in a better way. So keeping in that mind, the prescribed syllabus here, there are stories and poems. That first story, The Gentleman of the Jungle, and second one is The School Boy, third one is Around a Medicinal Creeper, it is related, and Oru Manushan. Next we have Babar Ali, and then If I Was a Tree, and later we have Watchman of the Lake, and then we have Farmer's Wife. Next, Frederick Douglass is deleted from the syllabus. And next, An Old Woman, and the 12th one, Two Gentlemen of Verona, and last one is Do Not Ask of Me, My Love. These four have been deleted. Keep in your mind that first one is Around a Medicinal Creeper, second one is Money Madness, and third one is Frederick Douglass, and last one is do not ask of me my love. So not talking much about the language and literature, I come to the topic today's the story, short story by Vaikom Muhammad Bashir, Oru Manushan. Oru Manushan. So it is written by Vaikom Muhammad Bashir. See, Vaikom Muhammad Bashir is basically, he wrote originally in Malayalam language. He hailed from, he is from Kerala. Basically, he wrote in Malayalam language and later his works have been translated into other languages of the country and in English also. So, Vaikom Muhammad Bashir was one of the notable writer of Malayalam, and he was not only a writer and he was a freedom fighter too. He is the person who had the experience of pre-independence and post-independence too. That he born in the year of 1908 and 1994. He is well-known Malayalam writer and a short story writer and novelist, and along with that he was a great human being. If you observe, if you read all the works of Vaikom Muhammad Bashir, the main theme of the story, the main theme of the works, the main intention of writing literature is to spread humanity. He is the reader who believed that on this earth, nothing will be permanent except humanity. He says that he believed that humanity is the rarest commodity on this earth. One must have humanity. So we should not suffer from humanity. We must have humanity. So humanity is the rarest commodity on this earth. Oru Manushan, through this story, he opens our eyes. Or at the end of the story, we come to know that in spite of man's cruelty, his violence, his wicked behavior, his selfishness, his inhumanity, but still everybody is good at their heart. If you remember a diary, those who studied in English as first language, you had read the diary of Anne Frank, the girl who was Anne Frank. In that diary, she tells that who had very cruel experience, inhuman experience from the rule of Nazis, Adolf Hitler's ruling time. And she had that bitter experience. In spite of that, she tells that I still believe, I know that human beings are good at their heart. In spite of their cruelty, their dominance, their meanness, their selfishness, but still human beings are good at their heart. The same thing, Vaikom Muhammad Bashir, through this story, he tells that apart from a man, even though he may be thief, he may be murderer, he may be robber, but in spite of everything, still humanity exists in everyone. Even in a thief also, even in a murderer also, humanity exists. So before going to discuss this, whom do you think, according to you, whom do you think that good human being, to whom we should call as a good human being or a human being? Is this the person who helps the needy, or the person who extracts money from someone, or the person who is being violent? He? Obviously, the person who helps the needy is a good human being. So the person who helps needy is a good human being. So Oru Manushan is a Malayalam title. Title of the story is Oru Manushan, means a human being. A human being or a human or a man, you can say. Oru means a, Manushan means human being. A man, a human being. So just imagine that all of a sudden we travel to such a place, the place is completely unknown, people are anonymous, we do not know the local language of that place. So we feel everything uncertain, strange. That we may speak or you may speak only English and Hindustani. Hindustani means Hindi, which is national language, and international language, English. And very few people in that place, either of these languages can speak. Only very few people can understand English and Hindi. And most of the people in that area, in that place, do not speak those two languages. What will be the situation? Everything is unclear, uncertain, strange, unknown. That one feels this experience, one will have this experience, that when you visit a new place, a strange place, you do not know the language of that place, you do not know anyone there, you are the first person, you are living there, you do not know anyone, you do not have any relatives there, and what will be the, you know, situation, what kind of situation, many predicaments fall, we will be in such a dangerous situation, we do not know anyone there, we do not know the language of that place, everything is uncertain. What will be the situation? Can you imagine? Or it might have happened with someone of you. So one has to feel, that feeling we will come to know after experiencing. If someone narrates such a strange experience with someone, we may ignore it. We may not care. We may not listen it carefully because it's none of our business, we think. But the same thing, it happens in our life. Then we start feeling the importance, that really the person's feeling is very, you know, strange. And if it happens, after all, if it happens in our life, then only we think about that. The same thing happened here with writer Vaikam Muhammad Bashir. Can you imagine? He asks us, the reader, and I tell you, this story is a first narration story, first person narration. As you all know, dear students, a story can be narrated through persons, like first persons, second person, and third person. Usually we have seen, we have read stories or novels, in that third person narration, always you find third person narration or first person narration, very rare you find second person narration. Oru Manushan, a human being, in this story, Vaikam Muhammad Bashir, he himself is a character, because it truly happened in his own life. So that he is narrating his own experience before the readers. And in the beginning he asked us to just imagine, you are the first person, first time you enter into an unknown place, the place is completely unknown, you do not know any people, you do not know the language of that place, but you know only English and Hindustani. So only few people knew or know only English and Hindi, but most of the people do not speak the language which you speak. And what will be the experience? In what a dangerous situation we will be caught. So that experience Vaikom Muhammad Bashir is now keeping before us, sharing before us, and is narrating in front of us, that is Oru Manushan, a human being. So in this story, what happened? This is not only a fiction, it's not only an imaginary story, but rather it happened in the life of Vaikom Muhammad Bashir himself. So he traveled some 1,500 miles away from his native place, and when he went there, not even a single man known for mercy. People do not know what is mercy, what is kindness, what is humanity. So in such a place he went, that is while he walks from so many kilometers from his native place. So in a So he went to a valley, so in a place between mountains. He started living there because he wanted to live. He wanted to earn his bread and butter, so that he traveled some 1,500 miles from his native place. And after traveling, he reached such a place. That place is known for cruelty. All the people who are living in that area, they are not at all known for mercy. They do not know what is mercy, kindness, politeness, humanity, love, concern, care. These people are known for their violence, their cruelty, their selfishness, and inhuman. They were not at all having any mercy. The people of that area, by professionally they were soldiers. I'm talking about that place where Vaikom Muhammad Bashir went and where he started living. And all the people who live in that place, by professionally they were soldiers, and they lent money for on interest, and they get interest and lead their life. And some of them who got retirement from their jobs, from these soldiers, and they were working, some of them were working as watchmen or gunmen at the banks and in different stores they were working. But those people were ready to do anything for the money. These people in that area, people give a lot of importance to money than anything else. You may not believe, the people were ready to even commit murder also. If someone offers them some money, they are ready to even commit murder. That shows that how cruel they were, how inhuman they were, selfish. Obviously, you can expect that all the people around Vaikom Muhammad Bashir are same. They do not know what is love, concern, care, humanity, mercy, kindness, helping someone. They do not know. They highly give importance to, value to money, and they can do anything for the sake of money. And this man is living in such area, and he hired a small room, a small room. On a dirty street of that place, and he was living his life by teaching, writing address in English. Vaikom Muhammad Bashir was teaching, writing address in English. Basically, this writer Vaikom Muhammad Bashir used to teach English for the migrants in that place. Many people have come from different states and different places, so that they were living in that area. Most of the inhabitants do not know writing address in English. If you imagine that, he is talking about few decades. there we were not having means of communication at that time. There were no telephones, mobiles. The communication could happen only through letters. And as you can imagine, all the people in that area were working as soldiers, and after getting retirement they were working as watchmen or other jobs in that area, and they have come from different places. Migrant inhabitants they were, and they used to communicate, write letters to their parents, to their relatives, so that through writing only they could communicate. So there Vaika Muhammad Bashir teaching them English, how to write address in English, how to write letter in English. That's what he was doing. His duty was 9:30 to 11 o'clock in the night he used to teach. The night time he used to teach, 9:30 to 11 p.m. And in that post office, the people who know writing address in English, and they could earn money. So these people who do not write address in English, who do not know English, they used to give them money. Sometimes they used to get 1 annas to 4 annas. Now as we, annas means paise, we say. So from 1 annas to 4 annas they used to earn money by writing address in English. Vaika Muhammad Bashir was also doing the same, just to get out of that situation, that if they do not want to pay money for writing address in English, they ought to learn English. So that Vaika Muhammad Bashir was teaching English to the migrant people in that area, so that he was earning some money. So he was earning his bread and butter, so that whatever he was getting money by teaching writing address in English, so that he is saving some money. Till then he has total he has saved 14 rupees was his overall earning by teaching address, by teaching writing, address in English, when he was teaching English to the to those migrant workers, laborers in that area, in that place. So that total earning was only 14 rupees. And one day what happened? So he used to teach from 9:30 to 11 p.m. in the night. And apart from this time, he used to take rest. So he was hiring, he hired a small room, on a dirty street of that place. And his earning was only 14 rupees. So he used to sleep till 4 p.m. Till 4 o'clock in the noon, afternoon, because just to save. Vaika Muhammad Bashir used to sleep from morning to night to next afternoon 4 p.m. The reason he was sleeping long time because he just to skip his morning tea and his breakfast, because he was not able to pay money for his tea and breakfast, so that he was sleeping so long that up to 4 p.m. So daily he used to wake up at 4 p.m. and after getting fresh, he used to go to nearby restaurant, and there he used to have his meal and his tea. The one day the same thing happened. As usual, he woke up at 4 p.m. and he got fresh, and he wore a coat and jacket and trouser, and he went to a restaurant which was very near to him. The restaurant was very crowded. So many customers were there, and some of them were simply sitting and chit-chatting there. Some of them were, you know, idly sitting in that restaurant. When the writer went there and he took and he had two chapatis and some curries, and at the end he had a tea, a cup of tea. The bill came, the bill of that, you know, the meal which he had. Now he had a meat curry, two chapatis and a tea. At the end he had a cup of tea. The total bill was 11 annas. The total bill was 11 annas. When he got the bill, that he started, you know, taking out his wallet, his purse from his pocket, he is surprised to know, he really got surprised and wonder that wallet was not there, his purse was not there, someone has picked his purse, his wallet. And you know, he started affrighting and slightly sweating that what to do next. Because people who gathered there, as I have already described, people do not know what is mercy, they do not know what is kindness, they do not excuse anyone. So when the man gave him that 11 annas received bill, so that he started searching his wallet, purse was not there, and he started sweating profusely. And what happened, you know, he was not in a state of mind to understand whether he has left it in his room itself or whether he has brought. Later he realized that he truly brought along with him, but someone picked that purse, that wallet. And you know, later what happened, he started searching here and there, and he asked a few of them, and later he went to the hotel manager and he told him that someone has picked my pocket. Honestly, sincerely he told before him that someone has picked my wallet. So when he said in front of the manager, he started laughing. Not only he, all the others who were sitting in that restaurant, he became the center point there. All of them started mocking at him, laughing at him, and he was feeling so humiliated. And you know, he was feeling so insulted that, you know, don't show these kinds of tricks don't work here, they won't work here. Don't show your these tricks in front of me. I have seen so many people like you. Keep your money and go from here. So then what happened? He was not understanding what to do, because already he has realized that these people were not able to be convinced that what he has to do. Later he requested them that, so I will go and bring money, but till then I can leave my coat here. So he took off his coat and kept before the hotel manager and requested him that till I come back, let my coat to be here. I will come and pay the money and later I will take. If that is your plan, if you want to leave your coat, not only coat, leave your trouser also, leave your jacket. He asked him to, you know, take off his shoes. So there is no other option. That after confirming that, he took off his shoes and he asked him to take off his trousers. And you know, he took off his trousers. And later they asked him to remove his paisans, now his pants also. Then later he said that, I'm telling you, nothing inside except this, I haven't worn anything inside. So this is comically, in a humorous way, Vaikom Muhammad Bashir tells that. So that they have taken it as an advantage. When he requested them that he was not wearing anything inside, but still they said that, some of them started, you know, shouting and, you know, laughing, as if they started, you know, he became as a joker in front of all the customers and in front the view of the hotel manager. Then all of them started laughing at him. Then he sincerely, seriously, I am telling that I am not wearing, I did not wear anything inside. They said that as you are saying that nothing you are wearing inside, I know that you are, something is there inside. So that they laughed, and you know, in a humorous way, Vaikom Muhammad Bashir tells that he became a, you know, he became joker there, and you know, all of them were laughing at him. And later he said that if you do not remove that, I will poke your eyes out, I will take your eyes out violently, cruelly. So then writer felt that, you know, what kind of danger situation he was in, and he started praying, requesting them. Not even a single person was ready to show mercy, kindness. Then he started, you know, praying the God that, oh God, what in a dangerous situation I am. What a dangerous situation I am in. Then save me. Then he started, you know, praying the God. Then when all of them were, all the customers, and they were laughing at him, they heard an unknown voice. An unknown voice. Someone said that. Then he was trying to poke his eyes out, take his eyes out. Then a man came and asked them to stop. Stop for a while. And he said that, what was the bill you said? What is the bill the person has to pay here? What is the amount Vaikom Muhammad Bashir has to pay here? They said that 11 annas. The man who came there and was a very tall person, whose eyes were, you know, looking so red, and he was wearing a turban around his head, and he was wearing paisams, a very tall person, and he said that what was the amount bill he has to pay. Immediately he paid 11 annas. Vaikom Muhammad Bashir has no words to say his gratitude, his thanks to him. And he said that he asked the person, Vaikom Muhammad Bashir, that man asked him to wear his dresses and shoes. After wearing, he put his hand around his shoulder, and he started walking along with him. So he, from that place to few yards they went. The man asked him that, what is your name, from where you have come from? So then Vaikom Muhammad Bashir introduced himself, that who was he, from where he has come, what the work he was doing, everything. And later he too asked him back that, I have no words to pay my gratitude, my thanks to you. Sir, may I know that what's your name? The person said that, I have no name. The person who saved, the person who paid his 11 annas bill, he said that his name was unknown. He has no name at all. Then Vaikom Muhammad Bashir, writer, said that, then if you do not have any name, I think your name must be Mercy. Said that you are known for mercy, so that mercy is your name. Your name is Mercy. Then he said that, and he took him somewhere far away from that city. There he asked him that, anyhow, I saved you. He introduced him, you know, in front of that man, and he said that, if anyone asks you that if you have seen me, don't tell them that you have seen me, or just say that you do not know anything about me. The man told him, and yet after walking some place, after walking few yards, and he took several wallets from his different pockets, and he kept before the writer that, which is yours, which is your stake. Then writer surprised to know that the purse, the wallet which he lost few moments back, sometime before, that the wallet was taken by the same person who paid his bill. And later he took his wallet. There were more than five wallets were there along with that man, and he took his purse, his wallet, he checked the money, intact, everything, all the money, nearly 14 rupees were there, and he did not take a single NS from that, and you know, he is surprised to know, and you know, the purse, the wallet which he lost was picked by the same person who paid his 11 NS bill. And later he said that don't turn back and go, you know, go straight and don't even turn back and CH me. The man also said that may God help you. This Vaidya Muhammad Bashir also said that the God, no, the God help you too. The where the thief who picked the pocket of writer, he blessed him that may God help you, may God bless you. The same Vaidya Muhammad Bashir also retorted him, you know, he also told him back that he also blessed him that may God help you too. Then story ends here. At the end of the story, we come to know that even the man who is a very cruel, a thief, a pickpocketer, and he was a murderer also, still humanity exists in anyone. Oru manushan, a man, a human being, was still existed in the in that person who picked the pocket of Vaidya Muhammad Bashir. So this is the outline summary of the story Oru Manushan. In next class, I will read the story line by line and explain you. I hope that you have understood the story Oru Manushan. Next class, I will come back to explain the same story. Thank you.